Hey, Crafty Peeps, it's Angel Holt with Angel Holt's Designs. Today I'm going to show you how to make a polymer clay pumpkin. I had a lot of response to the question is, do you want me to teach you how to make one? And so I'm going to do it. I had showed you in a previous video how to make a polymer clay pumpkin. I used the other half of the pumpkin in my project, but I'm just going to show you how to do it. So this will come with practice. Let me tell you, I had to make, do the pumpkin. It didn't come out right. Then I had to go back and, remold it. And then, it just takes practice. So right now I'm conditioning the polymer clay, and I'm using Sculpey Souffle oven baked clay. And it's in the color pumpkin. That is 6033 pumpkin. So, and you bake this at 275 for 30 minutes. Using a bigger piece of clay like this, I just go 35 minutes because I just want to make sure that it's baked. So I made it into a circle, as you can see. Now I don't want to warm it up too much because I've noticed that if your clay is too soft, any little bit of touching or anything will distort it. So there are times that I will create a section of the pumpkin and set it aside, let it cool back down, and then finish doing it. So again, I've only conditioned it into this ball form just for a very few minutes. Now I'm going to take it and I'm going to press just a little bit to give it that pumpkin-y shape right down in the middle there. I want that bulbous, shape to the pumpkin, as you can see here. Now, the first thing I want to do is I want to create the detailed lines, as you see here, the detailed lines in the pumpkin. And I am using, this is by Sculpty. This is a Sculpty tool set that you can get at Michaels, Joann's, Hobby Lobby. Now, these tools here are found on eBay or Amazon. I can get you the link to these. I think they're on Etsy too. I think I have one of my favorite stores saved, and they're on Etsy. They're very inexpensive, but they have different styles and sizes of tips on them to help you create beautiful creations with clay. So the first one I'm going to use the pointed end. Now you don't necessarily have to have these tools with a point because as crafters, we all have these pointy tools everywhere, but I'm using the Sculpty clay tools because that's what they're for. So it's a very long, sharp, sharp, sharp tip on here. And now all I'm going to do is start in the middle and I'm going to press all the way like this, go all the way back around, and I should start where I started. And then you're going to do that to this side. There you go. So you have a cross in there. Then you're going to start making your sections of the pumpkin. Like that. Now, you don't have to press really hard, but do you want a firm press in there because you want those indentions in there, and we'll go back and work with those indentions, but right now I just want to get the indentions in there. I want to do this one a little bit deeper. See, as you go, you can go around because as you hold this, the indentions are going to get distorted because the heat of your hand or the heat of the polymer clay. So you want to go back through and work with these. Okay. All right. Now, since I have my sections here, I'm going to go in between the sections and make indentions. You really want to, you know, style out your pumpkin with the indentions here. That's what makes it. You see there. All right, we got one more, and as you can see, I still want to keep that look of my pumpkin. There we go. Now we've really brought in the details of the lines. Okay, so now I'm gonna set it on my table, and now I want to just do like I am doing just little bitty. You know, you don't want, they don't have to be perfect. You just want to put those detailed indentions into your pumpkin, and as you can see, like I would do one at the top and then do one at the bottom. Like this, and as I'm going, if you have to, you can really bring your indentions in like so, and always remember as you go, just kind of condition your pumpkin, you know, like I'm gonna squeeze the top a little bit tighter in than the bottom, as you can see there. And see my areas here are not perfect and I don't want them to be, but I do want them to be deep for detail, and as you can see there, I'm just bringing in, now I'm taking my thumb and pressing down with this finger like that, so it has that pumpkin shape, and then I'm squeezing in the top as I go. See, now we're getting the pumpkin shape. Just think of how you want your pumpkin to look. Do you want it to look, you know, really scary, or do you want it to be a simple pumpkin? What is your pumpkin going to be used for? It's going to be used for a piece of jewelry, or is it going to be used as an accent piece on another project? All of those decisions need to be made. Excuse me. And as you do your pumpkin. And as you can see, now I'm going back up through here and I'm just adding more lines in. And I'm going to lay it down because it's starting to get warm. And you can never have too much detail, I think, when it comes to the indentions of the pumpkin, because it just adds to it. And plus with the handling, some are going to fade out and some are going to be very prominent, which again is just adding character and texture to your pumpkin, as you can see here. All right. So I'm going to leave that alone. I'm very happy with that, as you can see there. And I'm gonna let it cool down, and I will be back to show you how to do the stem and the leaves. So I'll be right back. Okay, while my pumpkin is cooling down, I have pulled out a green color for the leaves and a little bit of brown here. Now, these are combos that I made myself. As you can see, I have a little smidgen of them left. So you can do that. You can mix different colors of polymers and come up with your own colors, or you can use colors that are already blended for you, like this souffle color, and just work with that. But I'm going to show you how to do the leaves first. Now, this is how I do my leaves. So there are many different ways you can do leaves. So I'm just going to take a little bit from that ball there, and I press mine down onto my table, and I try to get it rather, not real thin, but just a little bit. And this is a just an acrylic rod where you can roll out your polymer clay. It is also by Sculpey. Okay, so now I'm going to take the sharp end of this, and pumpkin leaves are like in a heart shape, sort of like this. So I'm going to draw them out. And then I was like, nah. So see, I messed up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start over here and just kind of see, they're sort of in a heart shape like that. So now that I drew it out, now I'm just going to use this tool to cut this out. And again, this is the way I do my leaves. I mean, there's no perfected way, I guess. Everybody has their own, because working with polymer clay with your hand, you're never going to get the same thing twice unless you use some sort of machine. But then that's not guaranteed. So now I'm going to take the large ball-tipped end of my stylus tool here from Sculpey, and I am just going to feather that out like this and just work with it in my hand. Now, you can take, pinch that part off. See how it's warming up in my hand already? And you can just feather it out to a point if you want, like that. I'm keeping it rather thick around this area, but feathering it out like that. And then again, I will cut this down. So now I'm going to put in the lines so I can kind of see where I want to go. I put my long line down, and I'm just going to add the indention lines here. Trim that part off. Trim that part off. Add a little more lines in here. And there you go. That's my pumpkin leaf. And use your Sculpey blade to lift off the table, and as you can see, these will be baked separately. They're not going to be, put on there, but as you can see, looks perfect for the pumpkin. So I am going to set that one aside, and we're going to make another one. Again, just get your ball here pressed. Going to roll it out like that. Again, just kind of make a heart. like that. Then you can cut it out. And work on a non-porous surface like this bacon sheet resist mat. You can do that. Okay, you're going to lift it up and I'm going to put it in my hand. Again, I'm going to feather out, making the top part thicker and feathering out. We'll hold that right there. And feathering out the end part. Feather out the edges like that. Because you want it to look like it's just barely laying on your pumpkin, but it's meant to be there. So again, you're just going to take your ballast tool and just do that right there. Like that. And the warmth of your hand will help you feather the edges out as well. Okay, and then you're going to, now I'm going to trim it down a little bit, like that, trim it down just a little bit, like so. Okay, now I'm going to put my lines. Want some fine lines in there like that. Then I'm going to pull that down. And there you go. There is my second leaf. Make it a little bit sharper point. Like that. And I'm going to make it a little bit shorter. So I'm going to pull that right there. There we go. There's leaf number two. Okay, so now we're going to do the stem. Okay, had to get something to drink. Okay, now your stem can be just about any way you want, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll out like a really thick sausage link looking piece, or you can call it, I don't know what you want to call it, a hot dog or whatever, but it's thick. Okay, now I want it to kind of, you know, do a spiral loop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start in the middle here, and I am going to slowly thin out this section here, but I don't want it too thin, so that's perfect for me. Now down here is my base, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it like a boxy base, because if you look at a pumpkin's the top of a pumpkin, the base is boxy looking, it's square of the stem. So I'm just going to take my fingers, roll it, and just press it on all four corners to kind of give it that base look. And then I'm just going to take this long snake part, and I'm going to do a tight and I am going to cut it off right there. Again, keeping everything square. Okay, so now we have our stem. Now, take your pointy end tool here, and this is where you're going to add texture and detail into your piece, just like this. Oh, can you see? Sorry. Oh, where'd my screen go? Okay, there we go. You're going to take, and I'm going to see if I can zoom in just a little bit more. Yeah. Here we go. Yeah. And you're just going to start putting those lines in there for the moment. We're not going to attach it to the pumpkin quite yet, but I just want to go ahead and get these lines in here. As you can see what I'm doing here, it just mimics that old. And then if you want, you can add texture by scraping some of it away like that. You know how it's not perfect, it's not perfect or anything like that. There you go. I'm gonna flip it over and I'm gonna pull. Again, we're going to pull. I have to go help sew a 60-foot flag for the color guard in my daughter's band tonight. I will be taking video on my YouTube, so stay tuned for that. All right, so now it has that funky texture there. And don't forget to do the sides, you know, all four of your sides. And do the bottom just a little bit. Okay, so now we have the stem, we have the leaves. See, we have the stem and the leaves here. So now I'm going to go back to the pumpkin. Okay. Let me move my camera here. I got to make sure. Okay. Now, the decision you need to make on this part is if you want a scary pumpkin, a face on your pumpkin, or do you want it plain like this? That is the decision you need to make according to your what you're making it for, like jewelry, or if you're making it for just a prop piece for an assemblage art. It's just whatever you want to do. And if you want to put it on a canvas or something like that, you're most definitely going to have to cut it in half because, you know, this is very three-dimensional. So, you know, that's what I done with this one. I made a full pumpkin, but I cut it in half and I had a regular pumpkin plain, and then I had my decorative pumpkin. So you can choose what you want to do with that. And that's probably what I'm going to do here to show you the two variations, is cut this in half. And after we get it decorated and stuff. So my decision is I'm going to make a face on one end and then just leave it plain on the other, cut it in half, and bake it. So let me gather up some tools and I will be right back and I'll show you how to fix the face. Okay, all right, now what I'm going to do, the first thing I am going to do is cut this pumpkin in half. You can go by the registration mark and you're going to use your polymer clay blade. As you can see, it's an awesome shape. And then this one is going to be where I make my face. Okay, so I did make another stem because I am going to be using two sides of the pumpkin. So I'm going to set this one aside and now I'm going to work on the face. Now, what I like about the sculpty tools and stuff and the small stylus tools here is that you can really get a lot of detail into your pumpkin. So the first thing I am going to do is I am going to use one of my stylists here. I want to use the small one. This is a very teeny tiny tip. Can you see that? Very, very, very teeny tiny. Okay, so now I'm going to do the mouth. So I'm going to start over here and I'm going to draw in like that. I want it to be a length. And I'm just making some jaggedy as you can see, I'm just making some jaggedy shapes here, like real jagged triangles. And as I'm going back over, I am pressing deeper into the polymer clay. You don't want to press so deep that you distort your pumpkin, no. But you do want it rather deep for it to be noticeable when you add your ink or paint. So now I'm just going to bring this on up like that. Bring it on up. Press down in there. There we go. Now I'm going to take my sharper tool. And I'm going to clean up some of these edges here. Just get in there rather deep. Not too deep. You don't want to distort. Just kind of press. And this will take practice. Again, like I told you, my first pumpkin, I had to redo like 3 or 4 times because I was not happy with it. Now, what I want to do while I have my sharp end of my Sculpey tool, right here, I'm just going to add little bitty lines in there to give some more detail, as if it's been like pressed in there and like fine lines settled into the mouth. You can see I'm bringing it on up in there. Start from the bottom, work your way up like that, as you can see here. Then I'm going to bring some more lines. Okay, now I'm going to take a bigger stylus and smooth out some of these edges here, just to smooth like that. As you can see, I'm tapping in like this. Be patient with this process here. Okay, so there's the mouth. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to draw in the nose. So, kind of eyeball where you want the top of your nose. And then what you're going to do is you're going to, that's the base of one eye, and this is the base of the other eye. Okay. All right. Sorry, my allergies are really bad. Now what I'm going to do is very carefully without much pressure, I am going to lift this part out with the nose. Because we want a deep crevice in our nose. Okay? And I'm using the sharp tip here, and then I will go in with my stylus tools. Okay, now that I've removed enough polymer clay, I'm going to go in with a larger tip here, and the first thing I'm going to do is smooth this out. Like so. And then I'm going to take my fingers and kind of squeeze it inward like this. And take my thumb and you're going to squeeze it inward. And now you're just going to soften there we go. Perfect. So now what you're going to do, you're going to do the same thing you done here. You're going to add little extra lines around the nose. You know, just little extra lines. And if you see you need to go back and work on the mouth a little bit, you can do that. As you can see here, I'm just there we go. Okay, now we're going to do the eyes, and I'm going to use a very small end, and I want my eyes to have a curve at the top and a flat base at the bottom. That's the way I want my eyes to do. So I'm going to lift him up a little bit, and I'm going to switch him around here. As you can see, I want okay, now I'm going to give these a sharper look to them, and I'm going to lift out that piece of polymer. I'm going to do the same thing on this side. Okay, now again, taking the larger, we're just going to smooth it out. Go ahead and smooth that out a little bit more while I'm looking at it here. Okay, we're going to turn him around and kind of see what we're working with here, as you can see. If you want, you can press up like that and give him more of a scary look to him. Okay, we're going to press up, press in, you know, towards the nose, just like that. And now we're going to add wrinkles to the eyes. So you're going to start at the base of the eye. You're going to kind of press in and pull down, press in and pull. You're going to do the same thing on the sides and on the top. You're going to press in and pull down. Then you're going to press in. Now is when you're going to start working on the exaggeration of the lines. As you can see, I'm going to press in and pull down. Press in and pull down like that. Use your stylus tool. Oop, my bigger one. And look there. And cute. Super cute. I'm gonna press in a little bit more here because I really want the lines around his eyes really noticeable. So they look kind of sucking in. Like that. Do the same thing on this side. There we go. Now I'm just adding some more lines that I want exaggerated. And there we go. We got our pumpkin face. Okay, now we're going to add the stem. Now what I'm going to do so that it will have a place to go, like right here, I'm really going to roughen it up so that the polymer will stick to this area. And then I'm going to roughen up the bottom like that. Okay. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to marry the two together. Press it on there. And now you're going to use a flat end of the stylus tool here. You're going to start and you're going to start pushing. That clay. So basically what you're going to do, you're going to press and pull down, press and pull down. We are connecting or marrying the clay together. And now I'm going to use a smaller stylus tool. I'm going to press down, as you can see here. And now I'm going to press down because I really want this to. There you go. See? And now you can go back in and add more. And you can also take your tool here and kind of do some indentions to make it look like the top of a pumpkin, like it's inlaid in there. Like that. As you can see. Okay, so press that down in there like that. spring. See how that looks? Like that. And then I'm going to do the back and the side as well. There we go. And as you can see, I have finger marks here and I don't want them there. So that's another thing. If you start seeing finger marks or something really prominent on your piece, it means it's getting too warm and you're probably gonna have to let it cool. So just be aware of that and go back in and add what you need to, you know. As you can see here, I'm adding back some of the wrinkles and I want to kind of get that finger mark out of there. All right. Sorry you didn't see that. I'm not used to having something zoomed in so close. Okay. Just go back in again and just do your wrinkles. You know, that's what you can do. And simply, we're going to bake the leaves separate. And then we're going to bake this for 35 minutes on 275, which is the manufacturer's 275 manufacturer's instructions. And when it gets done and baked, I will then come back and show you how to put emphasis on all of those wonderful lines and wrinkles that you have put on this. So I will show you how to give it a lot of detail. Okay, now just imagine if you made like a little miniature pumpkin patch of these and made you some jewelry charms or anything. You can make you some fun accessories for your phone that you can glue on a case. It's just the possibilities are endless with this. So okay, I am going to install this one to this one and bake all of this, and I'll be right back. Okay, ladies, what I got was my mini Dina Wakely black gesso. I put it on my plate and I watered it down really well because you want to do a water washing on this particular project so that the paint will seep into the creases and give you that vintagey worn weathered look. During this entire process, I put on a layer, then I buff it down. I put on a layer, then I buff it down. I don't allow it to dry because I want to be able to buff it completely out. And I just use an old craft rag to do that. So you're going to do this a couple of times on both pieces of the pumpkin, as you will see. Make sure that you get into the crevices, especially the mouth and the eyes. You really want to enhance those. So when you buff away, lightly buff around those areas so that you don't buff what you just painted down. Now here on this piece, you want the eyes to be really black because it just gives it that set in look and that vintage look. And again, just be careful when buffing. Now here I am putting on the plate a acrylic paint. One is called Burnt Sienna. One is called Tropical Mango. And then one is called Pumpkin by Heidi Swap from years and years and years ago. This paint is like 7 or 8 years old, and it's still just as fabulous as the day I bought it. I wish she would really come back with these paints, because they're absolutely awesome. But the color is called Pumpkin. As you can see here, I'm putting emphasis on the vine part of the pumpkin, and I'm using those dark orangey colors again to help bring out the creases. I add a little black to the paint, so again that it will seep into those creases of the vine as it did the face, to give it that textured old feeling. I'm applying the black paint onto the leaf to bring out the lines of the leaf itself, giving it a little bit of a buff, and then I'll attach it to the pumpkin using glossy accents. But first, before I do put the leaf on, I am taking the tip of my stylus and I'm adding the yellow paint inside the eyes, just so like you're doing eyeliner of your eyes. You just want to outline the bottom and some up the edge of the pumpkin's eye. It just gives it more dimension and that touch of highlight that you need. Now, the rest of the video will show you how I take the same process and mix some paints together to do the other half of the pumpkin. And then, it's all about buffing and working with the colors that you want. You can mix colors and everything and have fun with it. I would suggest making you up some polymer clay samples, putting some streaks in it, and then play around with your acrylic paints and or your polymer clays to get the perfect color that you're wanting. Again, I used the souffle, Sculpey souffle color in pumpkin, and that is number 6033. And I want to thank everyone for stopping by to watch and request this video. I hope this inspires you to try polymer clay or pull out the polymer clay that's been stored up. Making polymer clay embellishments is really, really fun, and it adds awesome dimensional things to your projects. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video and share it. Those two things really, really help my channel, and I really, really appreciate it. Again, stay for photos, and like always, I'll see you in the next crafty tutorial.